Rick Santorum says talk of the middle class is Marxism talk. Let's see about that.
Don't use the term the other side uses. Who does Barack Obama talk about all the time? The middle class. Since when in America do we have classes? Since when in America are people stuck in areas or defined places called a class? That's Marxism talk. When Republicans get up and talk about middle class, we're buying into their rhetoric of dividing America. Stop it. There's no class in America, and call them on it. America is a place where everybody has the opportunity to succeed. We believe in everybody. We are the party that values the dignity of every human life, not them. Let them take what we rightly own, which is believing in every person and their ability in this country.
Rick Santorum says there's no classes in America, which by that, I guess he's saying that there's no such thing as rich and poor. So I'm going to go ahead and assume Rick Santorum doesn't know what class is. Rick Santorum's argument for this seems to be that this is America, where everybody has an opportunity. And no matter where you're born, whether you're born into a rich family or you're born into a poor family, you have a shot at getting there. It seems like he's implying there's an equality in opportunity. A quick reminder, Mr. Santorum, this is capitalism, a system that is based on and literally cannot exist without inequality. This is insane. This is like saying a poor black inner city youth had the same opportunity in life as Donald Trump, the son of a billionaire. This is an absolute lie. What Rick Santorum is saying, that anybody who goes out and talks about the middle class, how the middle class has been ruined in the recession, that we need to strengthen the middle class, is therefore a communist. Perhaps Rick Santorum might remember our old communist motto, "The workers of the world unite." But what is meant about middle class anyway, and what is the Marxist view of it? Primarily, what we know about the middle class, or where typically the idea of the middle class comes from, is Max Weber, a sociologist, who claimed that there are various tiers in society, and that therefore Marx must be wrong. It's not just simply worker and capitalist, it's a whole grade of things in between. Now, his argument is basically that there's these particular groups in society who have a common interest, and that these common interests are things like culture and paycheck and stuff like that. And so, therefore, Marx is wrong. Of course, all Weber has really done is create a different definition of class than Marx did, and then say he's wrong. He didn't actually prove him wrong, he just changed the definition of a word. To us as Marxists, we understand that the so-called middle class is really a combination of two things: petty bourgeois and a group of workers with a greater living standard. The bourgeois will always be the bourgeois. These workers are sometimes referred to as the labor aristocracy, meaning people who are still workers, but they have a very, very good living standard. They make a lot more money than the regular worker. But the thing is, the actual thing that defines their class by Marxism has not changed. Bourgeois is still bourgeois. He either owns the means of production, or he, in a way, could own his own. A worker is still someone who submits to employment. So that we can see what the middle class is really just a combination of petty bourgeois and labor aristocracy. Here's our main point. The bourgeois are still bourgeois, and these labor aristocracy are still workers, which means their relationship to the means of production has not changed. In truth, the middle class is a creation by capitalism to put a nice buffer zone between the rich and the poor. They take one group of workers and enrich them, give them a privileged position over other workers. Then they glorify them and tell them that they're better than the other workers that are lower than them. It's a nice little device that's used to divide the working class so that it doesn't unite together and overthrow the capitalists. It creates this false consciousness that they are somehow superior and that they should look down on other workers. In reality, they are still workers, except for the ones in the middle class that are actually bourgeois and petty bourgeois themselves. This is why capitalism is always defending the middle class, and why they believe that they're the real backbone of society, and usually do whatever it is they can to protect it.
The home of your own has always been the clearest expression of middle class security. For most families, that's your biggest asset. For most families, that's where your life's work has been invested. And that changed during the crisis when we saw millions of middle-class families experience their home values plummeting.
The U.S. was once home to the picture-perfect American dream. A house, a car, and a job symbolized the middle class as the core of a prosperous country. Yet, for an increasing amount of Americans, some or all of these are now out of reach.
The system has been biased against the middle class and the poor. When you destroy a currency, you transfer wealth from the middle class to the wealthy because they have access to the capital and they have a lot of benefits and they get the bailouts.
This is done deliberately to separate groups of workers. Believing that one is middle class and therefore superior to the working class in some way or the lower class is a false consciousness because they still at least are workers. They're just a privileged group within that power structure. They are still workers and taught to believe that they are better than other workers. This is a fiction created by capitalists in order to protect themselves. I reiterate my previous point. Rick Santorum doesn't know what class is. One more thing. As Marxists, we strive to create a classless society. If we already have a classless society, according to Rick Santorum, then comrades, we've already won. But I ask you, the audience, do you think we have a classless society? And, as a follow-up question, why do you think Rick Santorum would say that? Thank you for watching. Don't forget to rate, comment, subscribe, share on various social media. And if you want, there's some other good videos here you can check out.